Beaches. What's up, Beaches? Arthur here. Now, I'm continuing my series on sourcing for wisdom. And so, this really is for people born before 1965, people that like to read actual hardcover books. I've got Gratitude here by Oliver Sacks. And there's something to me about actually reading real books and being able to touch and feel it and hold it, which is really meaningful for me. And that's why I wanted to share this out with the world, because I know there's other people out there who like real books. And so I wanted to share another quote that I've been reading from this book, which has been speaking to me. I am sorry I have wasted and still waste so much time. I am sorry to be as agonizingly shy at 80 as I was at 20. I am sorry that I speak no languages but my mother tongue, and that I have not traveled and experienced other cultures as widely as I should have done. Now, to me, this is really significant coming from Mr. Oliver Sacks, because a very prolific writer, he has accomplished a lot in his life. And to hear him say that he looks back with regret that he didn't do more, that he wasted time, he wished he'd traveled more, he wished he'd learned more languages, it fills me with two thoughts. The first thought is, yes, everyone should live their life and they should go and experience as much as they can. Don't get caught up checking your emails all day. Don't get caught up just watching Netflix. Go and do stuff. There's a part of me that feels really strongly, go and live your life and go and do stuff. But there's another part of me that actually says, wait a minute. Is the purpose of life just to be so busy all the time? Because I think we can all agree that Oliver Sacks accomplished a lot in his life. He was really busy. He did a lot. And there's a part of me that wonders, okay, maybe if he had traveled, if he had learned other languages, would that have added to his life? Or perhaps, and I don't mean to sound judgmental or negative here, but perhaps if he had tried to do all of those other things, would that have actually taken away from his writing? Because I know for me, I have tendencies where I get these moments of motivation or inspiration where I say, I'm gonna go do something. I'm gonna go do a lot with my life. And then I start getting really busy. I start taking on a lot of projects. I start doing a lot. I start saying yes to a lot of things, but to the point where I actually start to take on too much and I become too busy and I say yes to too many things. And then I actually start getting buried in how much I've agreed to do, and suddenly I'm not enjoying it as much. And there becomes this point of diminishing returns. And so I'm all for living life to the greatest extent that you can and to experience as much as you can. But my question that I want to point out, or my question that I want to put out there, and this is really about me wanting to seek wisdom here, is where is the balance? Where is the balance between saying, okay, this area is my piece of expertise in my life, and I'm going to focus on this, and I'm going to do the best that I can here because this is the best that I can give to the world. And where's the balance from that? And taking on too much, saying yes to too many things because you're on this quest to live your life to the fullest, but to the point where other elements actually get watered down, and you're not living as much. Where is that balance between wasting your life and trying to take on too much? Where is that sweet spot? Because at the same time, I think it is good time to take some downtime, to catch up on sleep, to do some yoga, to exercise, to meditate, to catch up with friends and family. I think it's very easy to get caught up in this. I need to be productive all the time and accomplish a lot of stuff, but then there's other things that you miss. So there's always this nice balance. So it's my question that I'm putting out there to the world. What is that balance point of living your life well, doing good things, doing the right things, but not taking on so much that you feel stressed and anxious and nervous? So where is that balance point? Thank you.